In this video, we're going to compare the DeepCool AK400 to the DeepCool AK500 using this test bench right here. The information in this video can also be found on my website at pcanalytics.com, and the product links can be found in the description below. With that in mind, let's start by looking at some qualitative metrics. Both coolers show the side of the cooler that would face the RAM. With that in mind, both coolers will not have RAM clearance issues in most setups. Additionally, both coolers use a single fan, and it is possible to add a second fan on both coolers. In regards to installation, both coolers are relatively easy to install. Next, let's dig into the performance. We're going to cover two sets of graphs, one normalized by percent speeds, and the second normalized by noise levels. Note that these graphs are created by using machine learning models to help break down the performance using over a million data points in an open case. This means that performance may differ depending on your case's airflow and your CPU. To orient you to the graph, the left side shows temperatures corresponding to the solid lines, with the right side showing noise levels represented by the dashed lines. As a general rule, lower is always better for the data shown. With that in mind, we will first look at the fan's performance on an idle CPU, which is assumed to be using 30 watts of power. When comparing the AK400 cooler in red to the AK500 cooler in blue, both coolers perform similarly across the board in terms of cooling. Additionally, both coolers use the same fan, resulting in the same noise profile. As we increase the watts to 105, which is what the CPU is rated for, we can see that the AK500 cooler has slightly better cooling performance at lower RPMs, but this benefit diminishes as the fan increases to 100% fan speed. Next, we will look at the CPU overclocked to 125 watts. This shows that the AK500 retains slightly better cooling performance over the AK400. For the second set of comparison, we will look at the performance for a given noise level. The graph shown has noise on the bottom axis, while keeping the temperatures on the side axis. Note that lower is still better for this graph. When comparing the coolers by normalized noise levels, we can see that both coolers perform similarly with an idle CPU. As we increase the watts to 105, we can see that the AK500 has slightly better cooling performance across comparable noise levels. And as we increase the watts to 125, we can see that this trend continues. Overall, the AK500 cooler has slightly better cooling performance for a given noise level, making it the winner for this comparison. If you enjoyed this video, you should check out this one. Thank you for watching.